Hello, my name is Sascha Langfermann and I will present you my paper with the title Design of a 40 kHz inverse coupled inductor for an inverter system. Let's zoom in a bit. In this publication, the goal was to reduce the size of the passive component in the inverter while still having acceptable losses. In order to achieve this, a choke with two different core materials has been developed. The design process is shown in the paper. Now, let's start with the basics. We have an inverter system with two half bridges in parallel. Right here is the coupled inductor, which can also be seen as this equivalent circuit. We have a leakage inductance in each phase and a differential mode inductance. Through simple calculations, we can calculate this equivalent circuit with the mutual inductance and each of the self-inductances, as well as with the coupling coefficient. So this right here is the actual inductor, how it will be in the prototype. And we have a differential mode flux path and a COM mode flux path. Now the output current ripple can be reduced by the size of the leakage inductance, and a higher coupling coefficient K reduces the current ripple through the coils I1 and I2, while the output current ripple I doesn't change. So basically, if we choose a higher leakage inductance, we will reduce the output current ripple I, and if we change the coupling coefficient and keep the leakage inductance the same, we will change the ripple current through the coils. I will show this later in this presentation. On to the linearity of the inductances. Now, in order to calculate the inductances, it is important to know at what current the core saturates. We have two flux paths I just showed, and for the first flux path, which is the COM mode inductance, we can simply add up each of the currents, I1 and I2, and choose the maximum amplitude of this added current to know until which inductance it needs to be linear. Now for the differential mode inductance, it is a bit harder, because the difference I1 minus I2 is decisive for the linearity. The problem is that this difference changes when we change the coupling coefficient. A higher coupling coefficient reduces the difference I1 minus I2. And in order to calculate everything nice and easy, we made an Ansys Implorer simulation. And in Ansys Implorer, it is possible to combine an electric and magnetic circuit simulation, which is shown right here. And in order to integrate the magnetics, we first need an equivalent circuit, which is shown right here. We have the first leg, the center leg, and the third leg. And the resistances for each of the legs, the outer legs, are the same, since we need the same leakage inductances. And again, with simple calculations, we can choose whatever inductance we need in our model. So when we look at the actual design of the choke, it is right here in the outer core ferrite. The outer core is made out of ferrite, and the center leg is made out of soft magnetic composite. So the soft magnetic composite has a higher saturation at about 0.8, 0.9 Tesla. So this way we can actually reduce it in size. we choose ferrite for the outer flux path to actually get a higher coupling coefficient. Now, right here is a fast Fourier transformation of the current I1 for different coupling coefficients. 0 is basically uncoupled, and 0.5 is higher, and 0.95 is a very high coupling coefficient. The fundamental frequency of 50 Hz was neglected right here because it doesn't change with the coupling coefficient. So what we can actually see is that the current ripple is pretty high when we have an uncoupled inductor, and it decreases with a high coupling. So by reducing the current ripple, we have a smaller current heat losses in the conductor because the skin and proximity effects are less. This has been looked at in the next section, the current heat losses. We actually looked at different conductor types, the high frequency lens wire, flat wire, foil conductors, two different ones. So what can we see? The high frequency lens wire has the lowest skin and proximity losses, since the factor is 1. The flat wire has the highest skin proximity losses and the highest losses overall, and the foil conductors have like medium skin proximity losses, but they have a higher, a lower DC resistance value compared to the high frequency lens wires, and the copper fill factor is lower for the high frequency lens wire. So actually, even though we have a higher skin proximity effects, we have overall lower losses due to the lower DC resistance. So we lose the foil winding 50 times 0.4. Now we also did nonlinear 3D and 2D simulations to simulate the inductance values over the current values down here. So we can see here some pictures of the simulation. And basically, the outer ones are the inductances for the common mode path, and this one is a differential mode flux path. And right here, we also did a thermal simulation. We put in all the losses of the core, of the ferrite, the soft magnetic composite, and of course of the foil windings. This is potted in a resin, and this is then mounted on a heatsink. So we can see that in the center leg, the losses are the highest for the soft magnetic composite, but it doesn't really matter that the temperature is a bit higher because the material handles it fairly well. And for the ferrite, we are around 110 degrees, which is also okay. So we simulated the inductance values for the common mode and differential mode flux path in 2D and 3D. The measurement is the black line, red is the 3D simulation, blue is the 2D simulation, and we can see that the measurement and 3D simulation fits fairly well. For the differential mode flux path, or differential mode inductance, I would say the 2D and 3D simulations are basically the same, and they also fit quite well with the measurement. So in conclusion, the inversely coupled inductor has been designed with an analytical equations, circuit, magnetic and thermal simulations. For the center leg, composite material has been used. We could reduce the coupled inductor in size because of this, and the skin and proximity losses were reduced since we have lower ripple currents due to the high coupling coefficient. So, thank you for your time and for listening. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.